study about scintillation counting. It is based on excitation phenomenon. We have studied that whenever a radioactive radiation strikes an atom, it can cause either ionization in which an electron is removed from an atom, or excitation in which it energizes the electron and makes it jump from a low energy level to a higher energy level or orbital. When this phenomenon takes place in a fluorescent compound, then when this electron returns back to its normal state, then it emits a photon of light, and this process is known as scintillation. When light is detected by a photomultiplier tube, it forms the basis of scintillation counting. Photomultiplier tubes convert this photon of light or light energy into electrical pulse, whose magnitude remains proportional to the energy of original radioactive event. Types of scintillation counting, two types are there: solid scintillation counting and liquid scintillation counting. In liquid scintillation counting, this is the instrument. It has a light tight cover which does not allow light from outside to enter it. This is the photomultiplier tube which converts light energy into electrical pulse. It is an electrical pulse. It is supplied by a high voltage supply, and the electrical pulse is counted, or its measurement is done by a scalar. This is the lead shield which does not allow the radioactive radiations to go out from the instrument. It consists of a scintillation cocktail which consists of a solvent which is aromatic in nature. The sample is dissolved in the scintillation counter, scintillation cocktail. A primary fluid is present and a secondary fluid is also present. In this technique, radioactive sample suspended in scintillation system is composed of solvent and cap and an appropriate scintillator. This is useful for counting soft beta emitters. Most radioisotopes which are used in biology are soft beta emitters. The radioactive sample which is dissolved in scintillation system, it emits radiations which strike the solvent atoms and excite its electron to a high energy orbital. And this process, the atoms of the solvent system, they get excited, and when the electrons of the solvent system, atoms of solvent system return to their ground state, they emit radiations of short wavelength, generally in the region of 260 to 340 nanometers. This transfer of energy is most efficient if aromatic solvent is used. The number of collisions with solvent molecule will depend upon the initial amount of energy present in the radiation. Solvent molecules become excited, then they emit photon of very short wavelength, 260 to 340 nanometers. This cannot be detected by most instruments. Then silicon molecule is added, which is the primary fluor, which is generally PPO. It is also aromatic in nature. It absorbs this wavelength of light, 260 to 340 nanometers, and gets excited. Then it emits, when it returns to ground state, it emits light of longer wavelength, around 340 to 430 nanometers, which can be detected by most instruments, but some instruments still cannot detect it. So in that case, a secondary fluor is added, which is generally BIS-MSB, and it is also aromatic in nature. It they all have pi electrons which can easily get excited. So this absorbs energy of 340 to 430 nanometers and itself gets excited. When it returns to its ground state, it emits radiation of 480 nanometers and above, and this can easily be detected by any instrument. And the number of and the amount of pulse generated will depend upon the initial radioactive event. The advantage of scintillation counting is it is efficient for counting soft beta emitters like tritium. The second advantage is different Geiger tubes are used for different types of samples, but here any type of sample, liquid, solid or gel, can be studied by scintillation counter. Then the third advantage is fluorescent decay time is very rapid, and so the dead time in case of Geiger-Müller, in case of scintillation counters is very less, and higher count rates are observed. The disadvantage is the instrument is very costly. Quenching occurs, that is whenever the transfer of energy is interfered at any step from solvent to primary fluor or primary fluor to secondary fluor or secondary fluor to photomultiplier tube, then the amount of photon of energy reaching the photomultiplier tube will be less, and therefore a pulse of reduced voltage will be generated. Sometimes it can escape detection, so this can be a disadvantage.